Hello, today we will be learning about the blind spot. So this video will have two parts. In the first part, I will demonstrate the blind spot of your eyes, and then I'll go to the brief anatomical description which causes this phenomenon of blind spot. So part one of this video, on the screen I'm going to write two letters. On the right side I'm going to write a letter L, and on the left side I'm going to write the letter R. Now this looks paradoxical or counterintuitive. We have shuffled the letters L on the right side and R on the left side. I put that because of the ease to do the experiment. So coming to the experiment part, when you open both your eyes and when you look at L, and when you look at L, you can see R in the peripheral field of vision. To make it easy, I'm going to screen record and show that in between. If you focus on the letter R, then you can see that R is now very clear in your vision and L is looking more in the peripheral field of vision. Now, what you have seen both these letters with both your eyes open. Now, to demonstrate blind spot, you have to close one eye. That means you have to restrict the visual field to one eye. This is called the monocular visual field. Mono means one and ocular means eye. So suppose I'm going to occlude my left eye vision. I'm going to cover my left eye and I'm going to use my right eye to look at the letter R. Okay. Now, if you look at the letter R with your right eye and you keep the phone or your laptop screen at a distance, you can see that in the peripheral field of vision, you can see L. You are not looking at L, but you can see that in the periphery of the field, L is present there. Now, when you bring the phone screen, display screen more and more closer to your eyes, you can see that at a particular point, the letter L becomes invisible. Okay. Now, if you bring the letter more and more closer to your eyes, then you can see that the L will again reappear. So at a particular distance away from your eyes, you found that the L is remaining at an invisible spot. Okay, that is called the blind spot of your right eye. The same thing can be repeated with the left eye also. You can just cover the right eye. With your left eye, you look at the letter L and you bring the screen towards your face or away from the face to find the exact position where the R will become invisible. Okay, the L and R should be almost in the horizontal level to your axial plane, to your horizontal plane of your face. Okay, now what is the reason for this phenomenon? Now this is a horizontal section of the right human eye seen from above. That means I have cut the right eye and I am looking at the right eyeball from above. In this, you can see that the retina is on the back side, on the rear of the eye. The whatever you see in the world will be in front of the eye. Since this is a right eye, as you can see here, it is written, it is the right eye. So in that experiment that we have shown before, we have read the letter R. So I'm going to show that letter R here. So if I look at the letter R, that R will be falling on this point, and that point is called the macula. Macula is the region of the highest visual acuity. That means throughout the whole retina, whatever falls in your macula is having the most clarity. You will be able to read figures or letters or see the details of texture or the details of a face that you are looking at. Everything is possible when that is falling on the macula. But when you are looking at something like R, on the temporal side of that field, okay, you have a letter L. That was our experiment. When you close your left eye and with your right eye, when you look at R, on the temporal side of that field, you have the letter L, and the L will be falling onto a region where you have the optic nerve exiting. This is the region where the optic nerve is exiting, and that region is called the optic disc, also called the optic nerve head, also called the optic papilla. So this region characteristically has absence of photoreceptors. So whatever falls on this region is going to be blind. You are not going to get any visual input from any light rays that falls on this spot. Okay, that is called the blind spot. So the region corresponding to the optic disc is called the blind spot. Okay. Now this same thing can be seen on a fundus picture. Fundus picture can be seen by a fundus photography or by examining with an ophthalmoscope. You may see neurologists or ophthalmologists examining with a ophthalmoscope, and this is the picture that they see. This is the fundoscopic image of the right eye. Okay. And in the right eye, this will be the temporal aspect and this will be the nasal aspect. On the nasal side, you can see the most conspicuous feature of a fundus picture, that is the optic disc. So this structure is the optic disc. You can see the optic disc is the place where all these vessels are sort of converging. Actually, all these vessels are entering or leaving out from the optic disc. Now, on the temporal side, you can see this a little bit darker point, that is called the macula. Macula will be characteristically a little more pigmented because this place, the retina is characteristically thinner, and the retinal pigment epithelium will be able to cast its melanin pigment color more on a fundus image. So that is why it looks a little more darker. So this is the macula and this is the optic disc. Now look at a very interesting phenomenon. Macula is more temporal and the optic disc is more nasal. Okay, that is seen on this picture also. The macula is more temporal. This is the macula. Macula is more temporal and the optic disc is more nasal. It's the same. Okay. Okay, but when you are looking at the field, when you are looking at the field with the left eye closed, when you use your right eye to look at R, the blind spot will be falling on the temporal aspect. That means in the fundus, the macula is on the temporal aspect, but in the field, the blind spot is on the temporal aspect. Why is that occurring? The reason is the optic phenomenon. This system is actually a convex lens system. So any convex lens system will invert the images. You can see the L that is on the temporal side of the right eye field of vision, that L is falling on the nasal side of the retina, on the optic nerve, on the optic disc. So that is the reason for that inversion of that image. So that is about the optic disc and the blind spot phenomenon of the eye. Thank you.